G'day, how are you doing? Hopefully doing very well, keeping healthy and safe, and doing pretty sweet on this side of this. We're gonna have a look into this BenQ beCreatus DP1310 docking station. Now this is a different and also unique docking station on this market that I've not seen before. Besides able to input USB-C and also provide 100 watts to the device like a laptop or mobile device, this also has a second input, which is a HDMI input, which runs version 2.1. That's great because that's the faster one there. Now, this docking station has a button which you can switch between the two inputs. So it's like having a KVM switch built into a docking station. How cool is that? So this is very ideal for people who have either like a desktop and laptop or a laptop and a console. That is, which you can switch between the two inputs. That's what this is really useful for. Now, this was able to support three monitors at 4K at 60 hertz, or if you just do one monitor, it's able to support 4K at 120 hertz or an 8K at 60 hertz. So it's pretty fast there. Now it does run off your DisplayLink driver, so that's really nice to actually have that universal support there. So we're gonna do the unboxing and we're also gonna do the review later on in this video. We're gonna also look at the temperatures of this and what I thought about it, and also demonstration of how to install it as well. And as always, I will be putting timestamps along this video so you can skip to a different section. It may be interested to save you time. Now, without further ado, let's go and unbox this. Now, I've got my good old trusty knife here, my good old unboxing knife. Let's get the nice little whack. I'll just cut those two stickers here. Ooh, let's get that one done. Let's get that one across. And let's get this across. Now, let's get this one opening here. Now, it's nice to see the user cover. Now, we've got some quick instructions on the inputs, though it's nice, very clear to actually tell you what you can actually have down there. So that's nice instructions here. I got some warranty, so extra extended free warranty. Woo, that's kind of cool. Now, we've got the actual device. Ooh, look at that. That's actually got a nice little wrapping on it. Wow, that's premium. Ooh. Instead of using plastic, it's actually using paper. I like that. That's very sustainable. I like that. It's good. Now, we can straight away see this. Now, I'm going to just pop this around here in a moment. So let's just pop this here. Now, you can use this either vertical or horizontal. And I can see this is completely aluminium on the side. So it is passively cool then, which is good. And the front right, that is made of... That's actually kind of like aluminium too, or plastic. It's actually very good, feels very good too. Well built, BenQ, well nice. Yeah. Beautiful labeled as well too at the back, very clear to when it's labeled here. Now, I've got a big sticker that says DisplayLink to install, so you must have that to make it work. So we're gonna have a look into that in a moment. We'll have a look in the ports. We're gonna see what else is in the box here. Now, I'm just gonna try and grab what's out here. I got some more warranty cards and stuff. I'm just gonna put this on the side here. All right, now we've got a good old power cable. Now, we've got pretty much standard left here. Now, what else have we got here on here? Now, it's nice, again, I like seeing that this is all packaged in cardboard, so it's all very sustainable. No plastic, I hate plastic when it comes to that, especially ripping and stuff. Now, we've got a good old USB-C 3.2 Gen 2, just to tell you what kind of, and this is able to do 20 gigabits at 100 watts. It's a 4K 1 meter length in USB-C, and it's really nice. They even got Velcro, and these, I even have a nice little BenQ sort of label in there. Absolute fantastic. So you can, any excess there, you can actually roll around. So that's nice to see. That's 1 meter of all the USB-C cable. So that's pretty high grade. I'm gonna chuck that back in. And then we've got another HDMI 2.1, and now this is a cable, it's a 1.8 meters, so that's pretty standard there. This is probably, and again, we've got the same Velcro, it's a nice cable management if you want to tie any extra cables there. And this is quite, so this is again 1.8, very standard. So we're gonna use this a little later on, but let's just drop this down here. Really nice colors and just feels really solid and well built. I don't see any sharp edges on this, so beautifully made and very professional looking there. So nice little small device. Let's have a look at ports. We're gonna start on the rear side of the DP1310 dock. And I just wanna say once more again, how beautiful labeled and color coded BenQ have done on this dock here to make things easier and clearer. Now we're gonna start on the right hand side. We've got the DC in, so that's where we plug in the power, and then we've got a USB type C port. This is where you plug into a laptop or another device. This is input one. Now this does have a power delivery of up to 100 watts. So that's really nice to see. And then after that, we've got the main output. Now this one here has support of HDMI 2.1. That's good, it's fast. And this is the one that is the display that does the switching. So you, in my later in my videos, you'll see this one I've connected to the TV. And then after that, we've got another HDMI port. It's also 2.1. This is the input port. This is where you actually plug in your second input device. So this is probably either connected to maybe a suggestion of a desktop computer or a console. This is your second input device. So this is the one that actually outputs, and then it switches between these two input ports. And then after that, we've got the display port and then the HDMI port. These will then, these ones color coded blue, these three ports will be there, your free display that goes outwards anyways, but these ones won't be switching, only this one will be switching between these two input ports, just to give you a notice aware. Then we've got the Ethernet port, and then we've got three USB type A ports, and they do support 3.2 Gen 2. They do support 10 gigabits, so that's 3.2 Gen 2. And then we'll just turn to the front of this docking station here, and then you'll see another two more USB type A ports. Again, they're 3.2 Gen 2, so they have 10 gigabits. And then we've got a USB type C port, again, 3.2 Gen 2, and this also has the ability to have power delivery of up to 36 watts. And then we've got a headphone jack, and then we have a LED light. Now this gives you a status light of switching and also if it's powered off. And this is the main button that switches between the two inputs, between the two inputs there, so between. Now, first off, just to let you know, you do need to press on for a little bit time to actually turn this dock on. So just hold down that green button, that will then turn this dock on. Now just turning on to one of, I say, the bottom side of the dock, you will actually see some nice rubber bits here just as features to give it some non-slip. So you can see that's really nice, and just to give more stability. And again, that will be the same on the hair, even though this is, you'll see just the labels and stuff like that. But around here, there is some rubber bit silicone to actually stop it from moving around too, to stop, help it for non-slip. So very nice. You can either work it in your vertical or you can go for horizontal. But as you see, it's very beautifully crafted here. Now I could be working on my laptop. Hey, I think it's time for a break. I've got my Nintendo Switch connected to this BenQ dock. I'm just gonna press the green button and bang, I'm ready to play my console. Absolutely fantastic. Hey, look, I've just finished having my quick 5 minute break. It's time to go back to work. Press the green button and look at this. I am back on working on the laptop again. Absolute fantastic here. Nice and easy, just one button to switch between the two devices for input.
The BenQ DP1310 is connected to my MacBook and charging it, and also outputting to a 4K display. Now this has been going for about 3 hours. I can see the actual surface of the top temperature of the BenQ is around about 39 to about 40 degrees Celsius. I'd say probably about 39 degrees Celsius. Now the front of it, you're looking at about a maximum of 43 to 44 degrees Celsius, depending where you look. Now there is some hot spots, that's just electronics, that's just normal for the ports. And I'm just gonna turn this on its upwards there so you can have a look at the back end side of it. Now the bottom side is going to be hotter because it's been laying down, but even then it's about 41 degrees Celsius. That'll probably cool down to maybe about 39 degrees Celsius as well, and that is the actual operating temperature of this dock. Now my normal hand temperature is, at the moment, it has got an ambient temperature of about 36 degrees Celsius. It's another hot day here in Brisbane, and my hand is about 37 degrees Celsius, just to give you an idea how hot or how cool this is. This is actually not that bad at all to actually touch. I can put my hand here for quite a long time. I won't actually feel that much heat from it. It's not really uncomfortable at all.
We're going to connect the BenQ DP1310 with a 14-inch MacBook Pro which has the M1 Max processor. So that's a silicon processor. This will be very similar to M2 or M3 MacBook or MacBook Air or MacBook Pro. You'll actually get the same results. Now, I'm going to just get that connected to there. Now, I do have three 4K monitors connected to this BenQ DP1310 dock. And at the moment, you can see that's now all connected up, and I do have all three running. I'm just going to put this arrange so you can actually see that all there. Now, I'm going to just bring that up down here, so just to show you that it's actually currently in extended mode for this MacBook here. So it's going to right, as you can see that we've got the extended mode happening very nicely. Now I can also see it is charging, it's fully charged, and it is using power source, so it's good, and I don't get any extra messages from there. Now I'm also going to now, just for those that's interested, I'm going to close the lid down. So we're going to take out one of the screens. So before you had a quad display, now we are in hopefully in a triple display. So we have 1, 2, 3. Again, this should be not an issue. It's in extended mode. So you can see that's coming across very nicely. Now, those that's going to ask you, let's put this computer to sleep. Now, I do have a wireless keyboard and mouse, and that is connected to a dongle, which is connected to a USB at the moment. So let's do the sleep function now. So I'm just put this computer, this MacBook to sleep. Now this will be the exact same for a Windows computer. It seems to be the Macs are usually the harder ones to do. So that's gone to sleep. The movement here, that's another way to see if that will wake up the MacBook. I'm just gonna click, click, click. Oh, I can see it fully. It just takes a little longer to wake up through the display than it has waking up. I'm just going to just quick. Okay, so that's now all in. Now, I also know that this is going to be asked of me. When you actually do the switching of between the two displays, I'm talking about the, say, for example, I've got a console at the moment connected to the second input. So we're going to do the switch now. So I've got the switch, the Nintendo Switch on the second input, while I've still got the MacBook on the first input. So I'm going to just do the switch here. So at the moment, you'll just see, I'm just going to grab this, and at the moment, that's the second input. I've just pressed the button. So I'm now running on my switch. And what happens is, you will see now that the actual display is actually gone to dual screen, because I've actually got this now lid closed. But I'm just going to really show it to you over here, see if I can just bring it up on the side here. So what happens is, being still the dongle of the wireless, it is still running the keyboard and mouse, and it is going to the USB to C through to the Mac. So it is giving the inputs of all the USBs still to the Mac, not to the console, but to the Mac. And we'll also just show you the arrangement at the moment. Hopefully you'll see this. Now, at the moment, I only see two external monitors, which is should be it is. So the third monitor, which is the one in the middle, which is the one that does the switching, that will actually disconnects from the actual computer and goes to the second input. In this case, it's the console. Just to give you an idea of what happens when you do the switching. So if I just switch this one more time, and at the moment, you'll see this now will go to a triple monitor display. So at the moment, that is what you'll look at. So as you can see, we've got the triple monitor display here, back into triple monitor display extended mode straight away. Now the price of the dock is $299, and I'll put a link in the description below just to give you a hand on where you can actually find to purchase this dock.
To make the BenQ DP1310 work, you do need to install the DisplayLink application and drivers. Now this is for most universal docs, and it's very easy. Just go to your favorite search engine. In my case, I'm just going to go to Google and just type in DisplayLink driver, and it is from Synaptic, and just click on the downloads page here. We'll put the link in the description below, so just to make things easier. Now, it does support most, pretty much all operating systems here that we see. Now, Windows is very easy. You just click it and go through the wizard, just go next, 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 all the way through, and then reboot the computer, and away you go. Most of the time, you don't need to reboot the computer, but it should be fine. Now, I'm just going to show you the Mac one, because there is a little bit more, just about process to it than the Windows, as that's very straightforward. So I'm just going to go into get the Windows. Now I'm going to download this one here. Now probably the most latest one is probably the best one. Now I am running Sonoma 14.3 and I will just install this one here. So I'll just download that, read through the TNCs, things you just cannot not accept. I don't know why they bother with it, but yeah, you do need to go through that. Now that's just gone to my installation folder, so I'm just going to go to my downloads, and you just go through the actual wizard to install. Now just go next, continue, agree, install the application here, put in your either password or if you do your fingerprint to do that, and just let it give it administrative rights, and it will start installed. It's all done. Once that's installed, now we can actually click on up here. Now, if this goes away, you can bring this back up, but I do allow this just so you know what's happening here. This is more for alerts. This is the app for notifications. If you don't want that, you can click on disallow. But now after you connect the dock up to your MacBook, you will hopefully get a pop-up from a system prompt that asks you to allow this device to actually be working or to do the screen recording. It's not really recording the screen, it's just outputting through the screen itself or display. And just click on allow for that, and you'll see that there is now included a new message here to say, please allow screen recording permissions. And I'll show you how to do that. I'm connect the dock up now. Now I've actually got the dock connected here, and at the moment we're going to go to system settings, and we will go down to privacy and security. In privacy security, go down on the right hand side to screen and system audio recording, and you'll see the display link manager. Now at the moment it is disabled, so you need to make sure you have this enabled. Now just put in your passcode in there, and then it'll ask you, it will need to pretty much restart the display link manager software. So let's do the quit and reopen, and after that we won't have that expiration mark anymore. And also you may get a prompt for allowing the device to work when you first connect it. Unfortunately, because I've done this a few times, I've already allowed this dock already, so that prompt didn't come up for me. But if it does, do click on allow, as it does ask for it, and then you should be good. Now as for a couple of settings up here, you can actually enable the login screen extension. You can download that first and then enable that, so it basically allows it to do the login with all the dock accessories that's connected to it. And then of course it's probably a good idea to have launch automatically after login. Now you can also enable some very high experimental display modes here. You also can get the Apple Watch to unlock it at login screen if you've got Apple Watch. And the flux, now this is about warm colors at the moment. These days I think the Mac does this automatically. This is an old function, as this is to use for most older Macs in a way, but the newer Macs, they do this warm colors automatically through the OS. Now you can also allow it to power save the display once it's in clamshell mode. This is another one you can set up as
well. What a wonderful, unique docking station is this BenQ beCreatus DP1310 is. Now it's got a good selection of ports which are beautifully labeled and easily accessible. It's able to support three external monitors for both Windows and MacBooks. And it's got this really cool super ability to switch between two devices so simply, seamlessly, and quickly. It's just mind-blowing. It's not a new concept, but the ability to actually put it integrated into one device, why didn't people think of it earlier? It's just great. And it's just, besides that, it's so beautifully crafted, well-built, and just looks so professional and looks great on your desk. Now, I hope you find this video informative and enjoyed it. If you did and support my channel, smash that like button for me. Share this video, it does help me out. And as always, imperfections in life makes it beautiful and interesting. And I'll see you next video.